California Artesia Pioneers. I'm Valerie Baker.
And I'm Eric Renteria. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Go.
October 16th, Water Polo versus Pioneer at 3 p.m. at home.
October 19th, Varsity Football versus Pioneer at 7 p.m. at home.
Hispanic Heritage Month celebrates the important presence of Latino Americans in North America.
In our daily lives, we celebrate Latino culture with our family and friends.
We will be interviewing Hispanic students from Artesia High School to see what it's like to be a Latino.
My mom is from Fresnillo, Zacatecas, which is located in Mexico, and then my dad is from La Ciudad de Mexico, which is like the capital.
My mom is from Guatemala, and my dad is from Mexico.
My family is from Guanajuato and Tamaulipas.
Okay, so a specific tradition that me and my family do from our culture is on Christmas, which is like coming up soon, we always do posadas, and then on the actual Christmas day, we always make tamales. It's like a family tradition. Like, it's not Christmas if we don't like have tamales.
Tradition that my family does is eat pozole on Christmas.
Celebrate Thanksgiving, but we make tamales.
For Christmas, my family sometimes does las posadas.
I think the struggles, there's no struggles, I don't think, of being Hispanic in Artesia. I think we live in a high school that's like very diverse of different cultures and like race.
Do you check your phone every 5 minutes?
Today we're going to see what Counselor Zapanta has to say about it.
I find when I speak to students a lot that I do notice that they do spend an awful lot of time on social media, on Facebook, and not necessarily internet in the fashion that you think, like when you're just on websites, like YouTube of course, but they're also addicted to internet games that hook up to the internet. So I do think it's a real thing. I do think that we need to do a little more research on the lasting effects of internet addiction. And I know that's kind of hard because the internet started booming not until like a couple years back. There was internet, but it was very basic, like when I was in college. So it's just so much information that's so readily available. Even for me as an adult using the internet, I jump to things right away to like find out about stuff or see things. So I do understand the appeal. But I do feel like for students, it's harder for them to look away and get back to the things they need to do. And I do find that that is happening very often. So I think it's a real problem that we're facing, especially as I work with students more.
And now time for a commercial break.
I've been up 5 days, I can't get no rest. I've been up 5 days, I can't get no rest. Hey, hey, hey. I've been up 5 days, I can't get no rest. Stay inside my house, dodging questions from the press. She gon' fall in love, what did you expect? Everybody love you when they know that you got next. Got my gang with me.
These are my sisters, Lilani and Brianna, and today they'll be joining us to sell portraits. Come on, guys, come on. Your head is bigger than that. Come on, man.
I gotta draw my throat.
30 seconds, 30 seconds. Come on, man. Come on, guys, come on. Is enormous. Come on. Looking nice, looking good, looking good.
Okay, it's not how to work.
Wait. What's your favorite song?
Jungle by A Boogie with a Hoodie.
Why?
Because he has really good lyrics.
What's your favorite lyrics?
Walking through the rain with my Tim's on, stepping over puddles full of pain, it's a big storm.
Howdy by Smoke Creep.
Why?
It just has a good beat.
What's your favorite song?
My favorite song is Run Around the Zoo by Dion.
What was the last song you listened to?
Last song I listened to was Mr. Brightside by The Killers.
Justin Bieber, baby.
It was Tatiana by Blue.
Over 3.2 million students are victims of bullying each year. One in 10 students drop out of school because of bullying. Don't be the cause of someone ending their life. Facing peer victimization are 2 times more likely to have suicidal thoughts and 2.6 times more likely to attempt suicide. If you or someone you know is being bullied or is contemplating suicide, seek help. Help save a life, not end it.
And that's all we have for you today. I'm Valerie Baker.
And I'm Eric Renteria. Thanks for watching.
And we'll see you next time.